I think most of you know that I've been very heavily involved with our British forces since, I think, 2005. I've been going out to entertain our troops in Afghanistan, twice to Iraq, once to Kosovo, and once to Northern Ireland. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much. Well, the first day I went to Iraq was actually one of the best days of my life. It really made such an impression on me. It's hard to explain it unless you've been there, but having been there and seen, you know, how bad it can be, you know, I'm really, really been touched by it, and it's something that I want to continue to do for a long time to come. I'd like to actually dedicate this next song to all the men and women who are serving abroad, who are away from their families. You know, if they get the chance to see this, I want to send them my love and ask them, please, please stay safe. And when I heard this next song, I just fell in love with it. It really, really touched me.
In effect, the force's new Vera Lynn. How did that happen?
Well, I'll always think of the, you know, the force's sweetheart as Dame Vera Lynn. But it's, I guess I've been involved with the forces over the last couple of years. It started off by going in to entertain the Chelsea pensioners. So I go in and I sing to them a couple of times a year, put on a little show for them of the old war songs. And then I got asked to be part of the VE Day celebrations with Dame Vera Lynn. And then more recently, you know, going out to entertain the troops in Iraq. And I've just become one of the trustees of the British Forces Foundation, which is a charity that sends entertainment out to the troops.
Now, Iraq, that's a dangerous place, and, yeah. And you were shot at, weren't you?
We were shot at. We were travelling by military helicopter from base to base, and I was actually sleeping at the time, and we suddenly get this huge missile alert. The helicopter got dropped from about 2,000 to 500 feet in a couple of seconds, and you know, the pilots were just acting accordingly. There was anti-missile flares going off, and you know, it was scary at the time, but it certainly didn't stop me, you know, wanting to go back. And I'm going to be going back to Afghanistan and Iraq just before Christmas. So
what does your mother think about that?
Oh, she's not happy. When I came back and I said, Mum, you may hear on the news we've been, you know, hit, a missile was fired at us, but I'm okay. Oh, thank goodness you're not going there again. I said, well, actually I am. I'm going to be doing this a bit more often.
And you were driving around the streets of Basra, weren't you, in a tank?
I was. In actual fact, we were travelling by tank and also by tank transportery. But I thoroughly enjoyed it. It was just such an insight and a big privilege to be able to be part of the, you know, the British forces just for that day. And I really, really cherish the fact that I was able to go.
What do you find that it gives you doing that sort of work?
When I was invited to go out to Iraq, I had just come off a very sort of big successful UK tour, and it was just coming up to Christmas. It was, I think we went out on the 23rd of December, and for me Christmas is all about being with family, and I just felt like these
these wonderful people are away from home, they're not with their families, and I'm in a very fortunate position that I can do something. You know, if I could do anything to help the situation, then I wanted to. So I just felt it was the right thing to do at that time, and one of the best days for me of last year.
Afghanistan and to Iraq, and you went out there and entertained the troops out there, which is a lovely thing to do, and I admire you for doing that. How did you perform there? Did you have a band with you, or was it a backing track? And what did you sing for them?
That I had to take a backing track obviously very difficult to get out. Well, what we do in Iraq is kind of, you've got to make the best of it, you know, make the most of the situation. So we do our concerts in an empty aircraft hangar, two flatbed lorries, back to back to make a stage. They put one flag behind us, and we just get up, and I've been out a few times with Jim Davidson, who's the founder of our...
Haven't people suffered enough out there already?
But they love him. They really love him.
They
adore him, and so he goes on and does a spot, and then I go and sing a few songs. I mean, I was always a bit worried, sort of, how are thousands of squaddies going to take on opera, but I choose some things.
Katherine, like, they're not listening. Don't get me wrong, they're loving the show, but they got earplugs in.
All right, Mum, Merry Christmas. We owe me 3 weeks. Can't wait to have a beer. And this is my new missus, anyway.
And after that whistle-stop tour, as you can hear, the show is underway. Now, we are in an army camp, so as you can see, the facilities are rather basic. But that hasn't stopped our Katherine bringing a definite touch of glamour. Katherine, how are you doing? Are you enjoying yourself?
You know what? I've had the most fantastic day. It's been amazing. It's been brilliant from start to finish. I've loved every minute.
Why do you think it's so important then to come out here and sing for the boys?
Well, you know, I think everyone out here is just so fantastic. We've had the great opportunity today of going round to the individual little bases where they're living and working, and it's just amazing to see the circumstances, and they're away from their families for such a long time, and especially coming up to Christmas. You know, I got the invitation from the British Forces Foundation, which is a charity that puts on these events, you know, free for the troops, and I jumped at the chance. I'm just absolutely thrilled and honoured to be a part of this.
And then, what they'd all been waiting for, Katherine took to the stage.
Holy night, the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of the dear Saviour's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining.
And after a performance like that, it's no wonder Katherine's been hailed this sweetheart. Justina Simpson, Wales Tonight, at Bessbrook Mill in Northern Ireland.